check has now been cashed. We still pay Cuba every year to lease Guantanamo Bay.
We're still paying for that.
Yes, still paying for it. Yes, it's on lease, you know, legally. But Fidel Castro says he will never cash any of that check because it's blood money. So they keep piling the checks in Havana.
Okay, so they're not cashing the check, but we continue to pay the checks.
That's
And this is one of Castro's kind of things.
That's correct. We keep paying, but he's not cashing any of it. So we have to leave Guantanamo Bay. He's not accepting a dime for it because he believes it's blood money. Mm-hmm. Now, having said that, what are the problems in Cuba? Mm-hmm. You know, you have a lot of problems that are hidden. First of all, the demography. Some statistics that just came out, some say, well, Cuba is about, you know, 55% white, you know, 45% black. But then some statistics say, no, it's 55% black, 45% white. You know, the 55% black might make more sense because after the revolution, you remember there was a whole lot of flight, you know, of particularly middle-class whites, predominantly who left the country, you know, thus making the black population, you know, on the ascendancy. So that's a big problem. Up to today, you know, the racial disparity in Cuba.
It's a real racial thing in
Cuba. Yes, even though, you know, officially, you know, it's a classless society. But a lot of black folks in Cuba started complaining now about discrimination in Cuba. In fact, not very few months ago, a lot of black politicians and preachers in this country wrote to the Cuban government about discrimination against black folks in Cuba. The Cuban government says, no, things are better for blacks now, you know, than when Batista was in power. Which is true. Which is true.
Considering, yeah.
Exactly, considering, which is true. Yeah. Because even 90% of Fidel Castro's support comes from the black folks in Cuba because of some of the benefits they've derived from, you know, the revolution. But things are not rosy. You know what I mean? It's not a workers' paradise, as anybody might assume. Now, what might say, well, since 1959, what are the accomplishments of the Cuban revolution? What are its failures, you know? Let's start with some of his successes. Yeah, one can say in the medical field, you know, Cuba probably has one of the best medical facilities and systems in the world today, regardless. You know, in Africa alone, you have over 15,000 Cuban physicians and nurses in Africa working up today.
That's what you mean when you talk about Venezuela.
Exactly. In Venezuela, you have about 20,000 Cuban, you know, medical workers working in Venezuela. In Honduras, you have thousands. In Belize, the same. In Bolivia, the same. In most third world countries, in fact, overseas, you have at least, at the minimum, 100,000 Cuban, you know, medical workers working. What you talk about medical diplomacy today, Cuba is using medical diplomacy to spread goodwill around the world. Officially, since 1959, about 70,000 physicians have been trained in Cuba. Doctors have been trained by Fidel Castro. More than the whole of African continent put together. Okay? The School of America's medical school in Cuba trains about 10,000 physicians every year from third world countries, including the United States. You know, a whole lot of there are at least 1,000 Americans in medical school in Cuba. And they are going to school free of charge.
And of course, Dr. Madhu, that's some extraordinary information because we never think into now. When they send these medical ambassadors to these other countries, what about the medical services in Cuba itself?
The same. They have more.
The best,
exactly. They have more doctors in Cuba. Like I said, over 70,000 trained since 1959. They have enough in Cuba that they have to send out, you know.
Well, let's take this commercial break and then we'll continue that because I think that that's one of the most intriguing things that we are talking about. And of course, we'll be back with our audience following this very, very short commercial break.